Good morning, fellow mathematicians! Welcome back to another video. It's your Infinity Boy yet again. Check out the merch, okay? Oh, bruh. We are going to talk about our first approximation method when it comes to differential equations. Linear differential equation, first order, first degree. Okay? We are going to talk about Euler's method today. At first, we are going to talk about a little abstract stuff. You could say, okay, how to get to the algorithm. And after that, we are going to take a little detour into Python. I would like to show you what I programmed with Python back then and how accurate our approximation method actually is. It's going to be quite a cool video. Watch till the end. Back in the day when I still had to do modules like computer mathematics and numerical analysis, okay, it has been a while back, like 2 years, I like to program with Python in my free time, so doing a bit of stuff regarding palindrome numbers, calculating the GCD, working with the Collatz conjecture, or programming the stuff I'm going to show you at the end of the video. This time I'm not going to program everything through. I'm going to show you the program I have done back then, and I'm going to post the source code down in the description somewhere. You can find it on GitHub also, I don't know. But maybe you have never worked with Python, but you are interested in that. Maybe you want to try it out for yourself and work with the source code for yourself, but you don't know how to do that. Well, then that's the perfect day for you. This video has been sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare was humble enough to sponsor yet another video, and I thank you so much for this. I love working with Skillshare. It's really a great product. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 22,000 courses at the moment. Doesn't matter if you want to learn about mathematics, editing videos in After Effects, or actually working with Python, they really have you covered. So you basically go there, get yourself a premium subscription, and then you can take a look at all of those courses. So you don't have to pay for each course individually. You can just, well, try out each and every course and rewatch it as much as you want. So it's really a nice concept. And if you really want to learn about Python, that's your chance today. Take a look into the description. There will be a link, Skillshare something / FlambleMaths for this time, probably. And you can get yourself a 2 months free premium membership there. Okay, try it out for yourself. If you want to learn about Python, you have never tried it out before, but you want to learn all of this cool stuff programming with this math programming language, basically, then it's a perfect day. Try out Skillshare, support the channel, and now for the main video. So, Euler's method. What is it basically? Well, at first, I would like to take a look at a first degree linear differential equation, basically, okay? Or a first degree differential equation. Let's say y prime is equal to some function f of x, y. It could be, for example, okay, I'm going to put this here in parentheses just so that you get a little grasp of things. X times y, for example. It's a really easy differential equation. Now, if we have differential equation, we are going to get a solution with respect to y, for example, or with respect to x, times some constant. This constant is the solution to the initial value problem that we are given. Meaning, in normal case, if we were to solve a differential equation, we are going to end up with a whole family of solutions. Many, many solution curves that satisfy this differential equation up to a constant. But now we are going to pick ourselves an initial value problem, meaning y of x naught being equal to y naught, and we are going to work with this. We are going to approximate this very initial value problem curve. Let's say we are going to pick out this bad boy. Okay, I'm going to enhance this a little bit. It's going to look like this right here. And now we are going to approximate this curve using the simplest method possible, using the difference quotient that Newton derived back then, okay? Or Leibniz. I really don't care who invented differential calculus. They both did. They are both cool. They were both pretty fucking brilliant, okay? Not brilliant.org, Skillshare. They were fucking Skillshare. Now, this is our initial value problem. Meaning, it's a point on this curve. Let's say it's this one down here for simplification purposes. This is x naught corresponding to a point y naught. Okay, does make sense? Solution curve, and yeah, it's just a point on this curve. Now we are going to approximate this curve pretty easily using the difference quotient. We are going to choose ourselves a step size then. But at first I would like to construct ourselves a tangent line. I have yellow chalk right here, and this tension line is going to be put here, okay? That's the tension to the curve at this very point. This might ring a bell, it's the derivative, okay? We are dealing with differential equations. Now, choosing an appropriate step size, we are going to call the step size delta x. We are going to take a look at another point on the x-axis. Those two are delta x apart, meaning if we were to find out delta x, well, it's just of the form x1 minus x0. I hope this does make sense. Now we are going to go up to our curve, to our curvy boy. Now we are going to get ourselves the slope at the spot x0, meaning we are going to get this right here, okay, that's the tangent line yet again, working with the derivative, that's the idea right here. And then we are going to take a look at our curve that we have up here, our tangent line, our original one. This is going to construct our new curve. And now we are going to make a projection upwards, meaning we are going to take this tangent and we are going to put it up here, up until it meets at x naught at this new curve, at this tangent line. Okay, I hope this does make sense. This thing right here is just our extended x1, not x naught, x1. We are going to put it up here. It's going to lie exactly here. Okay, and we are going to repeat this process, for example, up until xn. Okay, this right here is our xn, meaning we are going to go up here, we are going to take our slopey boy, and then we are going to go up here, make the projection right here, going to put it here, it's going to look like this. Okay, and after that, if we have done n iterations, we are going to have this right here as our approximated solution curve. One thing you might notice is the smaller the step size gets, the closer we actually get to our curve, meaning this slope, this tangent line is going to go down here and down here and so on, up until we approximate this original solution curve perfectly. That's the idea right here, okay? This is just Euler's method. How can we put this into easier terms? How are we going to get this new solution curve? Now, one thing I want you guys to notice is that our x1 is going to correspond to a new spot y1, okay, on our new solution curve. Xn is going to correspond to a yn value right here on a new solution curve. We're going to work with this right here. This is just basically the slope at the point xn, yn. For this, I would like to take a look at the easiest approach, just taking the difference quotient that you know and love. Okay, if we take a look at the derivative, y prime, we can define it rigorously as the limit as our step size goes to zero of, well, in this case, we are going to have y of x plus delta x. I have to think about everything I do right here as always, minus y of x over delta x. Now, we don't let our step size go to zero. We are going to take a fixed step size, for example, one instead of zero, okay? Meaning, we are not going to take a look at limiting process. We are just going to take a look at this algebraic thing. Now we can actually solve for y of x plus delta x. This is the appropriate thing to do right here. Okay, you are going to see why this makes sense in a second. It's a recursively defined algorithm. Multiply both sides by delta x, it's not equal to zero, and then add this thing on both sides, leaving us with y of x plus delta x being equal to y of x plus delta x times y prime, in this case of x. And now we are going to do some discrete magic right here. This thing is basically just a discrete derivative, okay? I have introduced this before when dealing with the derivative of x factorial, for example, okay? Taking the discrete derivative with a step size of one. Now, we are going to make this discrete. We have discrete values right here, xn and yn, meaning we are just going to plug it in, okay? Now, we are going to say, let's take a look at xn, that's our spot. Our step size is a fixed thing, okay? It's of this form right here. Our step size is always xn plus 1 minus xn, okay? If we translate this, delta x from this to generalized xn is just xn plus 1 minus xn. Meaning what we can also do is we can solve for xn plus 1 being equal to delta x plus xn. And this is really good because delta x plus xn is simply xn plus 1, so y of xn plus 1 being equal to y of xn, well, it's just going to correspond on our new solution curve to yn. And then we have plus delta x of y prime is always f of x comma y, and don't forget y is also a function with respect to x, so y of xn in this case. So we are going to get f of xn comma y of xn is nothing other than yn. Meaning y of xn plus 1, we are going to simplify this, is nothing other than y of n plus 1. And this way we have defined ourselves a recursive algorithm. How does this make sense? Well, we can go through this process right here n times up until we reach our original initial value problem, the only known thing that we really have. How can we go from there? Well, the cool thing is we have a formula for yn plus 1, meaning our only unknown right here is our yn. How are we going to get to yn? Well, we are going to take this algorithm. Yn is just this formula with an n minus 1 plugged in, being equal to y of n minus 1 plus delta x f of x n minus 1 comma y n minus 1. And I hope you can see the pattern. The only unknown thing in here is at the moment y of n minus 1. We are going to go through this process once again. Y of n minus 1 is just this thing with n minus 2 plugged in. We are going to go downwards up until we reach a certain point, namely y of 1 is thus everything just with a 0 plugged into here. 1 minus 1 is 0. So y naught, which is the solution to our initial value problem, the only known thing that we have, plus delta x f of x naught comma y naught. This is our recursive algorithm. And if we do this process n times, we can actually approximate our curve at a certain point. Okay? And this is how it is. Reduce the step size and you're going to get to the exact solution of our differential equation. There's also a different way to find this out using Taylor series, for example. But this is just an exercise left for a reader, okay? You are just going to do the Taylor series of this thing at the spot xn, okay? And then you are basically done. I'm going to see you guys in Python, and don't forget to check out Skillshare. Love you guys. Ciao. Okay. Let us take a look at what we actually have right here. This is the first script for Euler's method of y prime being equal to x, okay? So what we have here is the diffq, and this is a function of a. And then we have the initial value problem, which we can plug in later in the game. Then we have the exact solution to the differential equation. That's a really easy one to solve, x squared over 2 plus some arbitrary constant c, and we are going to get the constant c out of our initial value problem, okay, that we have defined ourselves up here. Then I would like to find the error between the approximated solution in Euler's method and also the exact solution, okay, so this is going to give us the formula for the error. And also we are going to find ourselves Newton's method, meaning we are going to put in the step size, we are going to put in the initial value problem, and so on and so forth. I'm going to run this bitch, and we are going to see how it works out. Okay, this was a nice Max Mofo reference up there. Okay, initial value for our x. Let us say 1. Initial value for the y is going to give us 1. How many iterations do we want to do? Let's say 12. And which step size? Let's say step size 1. Okay, here we go. You see, at first the error is 0 because our initial value problem is exactly also a solution to our differential equation. And after that, after the first iteration, we are going to get y1 is equal to 2.0, and the exact value would be 2.5, error of 20%. And it's going to go on and on right here. Like I said, I'm going to post the script, the source code down there somewhere in the description.
If we go further and further, we see that our step size 1 is already pretty good. Okay, we are going to get closer and closer to the exact solution. If we go down here to the 12th iteration, why 12? Our approximate solution is pretty close, actually, to our exact solution. So let me go through the script yet again. We are going to choose a different step size, etc. F5, okay. The initial value for x, we are going to propose it's 1 yet again. And what for y01, then 12, and the step size 0.001. Okay, let us see. Can you see that? At first, the error is quite big. Okay, but it's going to get arbitrarily small. Okay, we are going to have a really small error right here. It's going to be really close. The smaller the step size, the better. Okay, it's just how differentiation works. I have another sample for a bit of a more sophisticated differential equation, Euler method 2, that's what I called it. And let us take a look. We are going to have the differential equation y prime plus 2y being equal to 2 minus e to negative 4x power. It's the same spiel right here, and you can put in the iterations, etc. Now, initial value for x is going to be 1. Let's see if this even works. For y is 0, how many iterations? 12, which step size 1. Doesn't work out because this initial value problem doesn't seem to be a solution to our differential equation. Okay, let's give it another shot. let me see. Is this the one? Yeah, this is the right one. Let's say we're going to have 1 and 1, 12 and 1. There it goes. Okay. At first, we are kind of close. We are getting closer, but then it does diverge. You see, our error is pretty much oscillating a bit, okay, between 7 and 3%. This function seems to be oscillating, and so does our error. I'm not certain about the analytical solution. Let us make the step size a little bit smaller, such that you can see, for example, initial values yet again, 1, 1. And then 12 iterations and 0.0001. Sometimes it's not good to put in values which are close to 0. Sometimes it's better to actually choose other step sizes, bigger step sizes. We are going to see if the error grows or if it's going to get smaller. Yeah, at first we have a small error. And it's going to get a bit bigger over time. Okay, at first we had 0.00 and now we are at 0.01 something. So you see, this is Euler's method. You can easily implement it in Python. And I thank you guys for watching. Up until next video, have a flambe day. Ciao.